Now let's see about the installation part. Under installation session, we will cover the below listed topics for installation of WordPress, starting with the things to know before installing WordPress, things you need to do to install WordPress, then famous five install methods, detailed instructions for download and extract, create the database and user with various methods like using cPanel, using lunarpage.com's custom cPanel, using phpMyAdmin, using MySQL client, using direct admin, set up WordPress configuration files, upload the files in the root directory or in the subdirectory, running the install scripts, set up configuration files, finishing installations, then install script troubleshootings, common installation problems, automated installations, 5-minute media template, one-click installers like from Fantastico or Softiculous, and installation instructions in other languages, installing the multiple blogs and installing WordPress on your own computer, local installation instructions, software applications ready to use, and easy 5-minute WordPress installation on Windows, that is on your local PC, using the WAMP server and installing WordPress at AWS and installing through WP's client. So let's start with covering of the topics with starting the few things to know before installing WordPress. WordPress is well known for its ease of installation. Under most circumstances, installing WordPress is very simple process and takes less than 5 minutes to complete. Many web hosts now offer tools, example Fantastico or Softiculous, to automatically install WordPress for you. However, if you wish to install WordPress yourself, this session will help you. Now, with automatic upgrading, it's even easier. This session will help you whether you go for famous 5-minute installation, that is automated installation, or require more detailed installation information on this guide. There are few things listed over here. Things to know before you begin installing WordPress: the famous 5-minute installations, detailed installation instructions, common installation problems, WordPress in your language, installation WordPress in your language, how to install multiple blogs, how to install on your computer, easy 5-minute installation on Windows using WAMP server or AWS, or installation with the configuration files, and getting started with WordPress. So these are the features that we'll be covering in the installation process, and to start with few things to know before installing WordPress. Before you begin to install, there are few things you need to have to do. These are: access your web server via shell or FTP. You need a text editor and an FTP client, your web browser of your choice. Things you need to do to install WordPress: to begin your installation by checking to ensure that you and your web host have the minimum requirements to run the WordPress, download the latest release of WordPress from the wordpress.org website, unzip the downloaded file to your folder on your hard drive, be prepared with the secured password for your secret key. And in case if you require, you can print out the information provided in this page and keep it handy during the installation so that you can refer it easily. To start with, we'll see the famous 5-minute installation. Here's a quick version of the instructions for those who are already comfortable with performing such installations. The more detailed instructions are yet to follow. So if you are not comfortable with renaming files, step 3 is optional and you can skip it as the install program will create the WordPress configuration file for you. The starting with the first step is download and unzip the WordPress package if you haven't done already. Create a database for WordPress on your web server as well as MySQL user who has all privileges for accessing and modifying it. The optional part that I have already mentioned is find and rename the WordPress configuration file, that is the sample file, to WordPress configuration.php, and then edit the file by seeing the editing WP configuration file session that we'll be covering next, and add your database information. Upload the WordPress file to the desired location on your web server. The most recommended is the root of your domain. If you want to integrate WordPress into the root of your domain, example your domain.com, then move or upload all the content of this unzipped WordPress directory, excluding the WordPress directory itself, into the root directory of your web server. If you want to have your WordPress installation in its own subdirectory on your website, example your domain.com/blog, then create a blog directory on your server and upload the contents of the unzipped WordPress package to your directory via FTP. And there is a small note that if your FTP client has an option to convert files names to lowercase, make sure it is disabled. Run the WordPress installation script by accessing the URL in a web browser, and this should be the URL where you uploaded the WordPress files. If you installed WordPress in the root directory, it should be visited as your domain.com. And if you installed in a subdirectory which you have created, like the blog as we discussed over here earlier, then you can use the URL yourdomain.com/blog, and that's it. The WordPress should be installed. Now let's see the detailed instructions. To start with, download and extract. If you work on your own computer, then most Linux distributions you can install WordPress automatically on a Mejia, that is KDE, thanks to Mejia Control Center, on Fedora 20, that is GNOME, and you will not find it in the software, which only includes application for proper GUI, but can install from there a package called packages containing the application packages alias software installs, and thanks to the packages and you can install WordPress. We advise you to install phpMyAdmin at the same time if it is not installed. You can download and unzip the WordPress package from wordpress.org/downloads, and if you will be uploading WordPress to a remote web server, download the WordPress package to your computer with a web browser and unzip the package. If you will be using a FTP, skip to the next step. Uploading the files is covered later. If you have cell access, then your web server and are comfortable using control-based tools, you may wish to download WordPress directly to your web server using wget or Lynx or another console-based web browser. If you want to avoid FTPing, wget is located at the URL wordpress.org/latest.tar.gz, then unzip the package using the -xzvf latest.tar.gz command, that is using the command line feature, and WordPress package will extract into the folder called WordPress in the same directory that you downloaded latest.tar.gz. The second step is to create a database and a user. That is, once you have downloaded the package, extracted and uploaded the file into the directory of your server, that could be a root directory or a sub root directory. The second thing, you need to create the database and the passwords. So let's see about creating the database and a user and the passwords for the same. So if you are using a hosting provider, you may already have a WordPress database set up for you, or there may be automated setup solutions which you can do so. You can check your hosting providers, support pages or your control panel for clues about whether or not you will be able to create one manually. If you determine that you will need to create one manually, you can follow the instructions for accessing phpMyAdmin on various servers, or follow the instructions for using cPanel or using phpMyAdmin, which we'll be covering below. If you are installing WordPress on your own web server, then follow using phpMyAdmin or using MySQL client instructions, which we'll be covering in the next sessions, to create your WordPress username and database. If you have only one database and it is already in use, you can install WordPress in it. Just make sure to have a distinct prefix for your tables and to avoid overwriting any existing database table. Now we will see how to install using a cPanel. If your hosting provider supplies the cPanel hosting control panel, you can follow these simple instructions to create your WordPress usernames and database. A more complete set of instructions for using cPanel to create a database and user can be found in using cPanel sessions, which will be coming up in the future sessions. Log into your cPanel, click on MySQL database wizard icon under the database section. In step 1, create a database, enter the database name and click next step. Step 2 is to create database user, enter the database username and a password, make sure to use strong password, then click create the user. Then step 3 is to add user to the database. You can click all the privileges checkbox and click next step. And step 4 is complete the task, note that the database name and server. Write down the values of the hostname, username, database name and the password you chose. And you should note that hostname will usually be the local host, or you can use the domain name. This was the installation using the cPanel. Now let's see how to use it using the lunarpages.com's custom cPanel. So Lunar Pages has developed their own version of cPanel. Log into your control panel, go to the control panel, click on the button on the left panel labeled go to LPCP, that is Lunar Page Control Panel. Go to MySQL Manager and add the user name and database name, but leave the host name as the default IP number. Note that the IP address of the database on the right, which is different from the default IP number of the host indicated in the above step. When modifying the WordPress configuration file, use the database IP number, not the local host. This is to enable you to connect to the database, as it could be located on a different platform or a different location or a different server. When modifying the WordPress config file .php file, be sure to use the full name of the database and username, typically the account name underscore name yourself created. Refer to the lunarpages.com more information on their website. And now we will see how to use the phpMyAdmin for this purpose. And if your web server has phpMyAdmin installed, you may follow these instructions to create your WordPress usernames and database. If you work on your computer, most Linux distributions, you can install phpMyAdmin automatically. Note, these instructions are written for PHP MyAdmin version 3.5, and PHP MyAdmin user interface can vary slightly between different versions. So if a database relating to WordPress does not already exist in the database dropdown on the left, create one. Choose a name for your WordPress database. WordPress or blog are good, but you can use your own if you want to. But most hosting services, especially shared hosting, will require a name beginning with your username there and an underscore between. That is a prefix to be used. So even if you work on your own computer, we advise you to check now your hosting service requirements so that you can confirm with them on your own server and would be able to transfer your database without modifications when it will be ready. Enter the chosen database name in the create database and field and choose the best collation for your language and encoding. In most cases, it is better to choose in the UTF-8 series, and if you don't find your language, to choose UTF underscore Unicode underscore CA is good. And you can use the you can refer the stackoverflow.com for more information on the UTF Unicodes. And here we can see an image with the databases and choosing the collations over here. So after naming the database, your file label WordPress, and choosing the collation here, Unicode general underscore CI, and click on the create button. You can then click the PHP MyAdmin icon and click on the upper left to return to the main page and click the users tab. If a user relating to the WordPress does not already exist in the list of users, then create one. Now let's see about adding the users. Click add user, and this is then icon in the upper left to return to the main page, and then click users tab. If your user relating to the WordPress does not already exist in the list of users, then you can create one. So click add user, choose a username for WordPress, and WordPress is good. You can use other name if you wish to, and enter it in the username field, and be sure to use the text field is selected from the drop-down. Choose a difficult to guess password, ideally containing combination of upper and lower cases, letters, numbers and special characters, symbols, etc., and enter it in the password field, and be sure to use the text field is selected from the drop-down. Re-enter the password in the retype field. Write down the username and password you chose so that you can use it the next time if the need be. Leave all the options under global privileges at your defaults and click go button. Return to the user screen and click edit privileges icon on the user, and you have just created for the WordPress in the database specific privilege section. Select the database you have just created for the WordPress under the add privileges to the following database drop down. The page will refresh with privileges for that database, and then you can click on check all to select all privileges and click go. On resulting page, make a note of the host name listed after the server at the top of the page. So this will usually be the local host. Now let's see about using the MySQL client. You can create MySQL user and database quickly and easily by running MySQL from the shell. That is, in case you have shell extensions enabled in your control panel. The syntax is shown below over here on this slide. and the dollar sign is the command prompt. So from the dollar prompt, you can use MySQL dash u admin username minus p, then enter password, welcome to MySQL monitor, and command ends with semicolon or slash g, which you can see over here on the slide. And your MySQL connection ID is 5340 to server version 3.23.54, and you can type help or slash h for help. You can type slash c to clear the buffers. The slash that you'll be using would be the backslash before using the help for slash h, that is backslash h or backslash c. So now let's see the few examples over here. That the root is also the admin username. It is safer practice to choose a so-called mortal account as your MySQL admin, so that you are not entering the command MySQL as the root user on your system. Anytime you can avoid doing work as root, you decrease your chances of being exploited. The name you use depends on the name you assign as a database administrator using MySQL admin. WordPress or blog are good values for database usernames. WordPress is good value for WordPress username, but you should realize that since it is used here, the entire world will know it too. Hostname will usually be the local host. If you don't know what this value should be, check with your system administrator if you are not the admin for your WordPress host. If you are the system admin, consider using a non-root account to administer your database. Password should be a difficult to guess password, ideally containing the combination of upper and lower cases, numbers, symbols, special characters, etc. One good way of avoiding the use of word found in a dictionary is to use the first letter of each word in the phrases that you find easy to remember. If you need to write these values somewhere, avoid writing them in a system that contains the things protected by them. You need to remember the values used for the database name, WordPress username, hostname, and password. Of course, since they are already in or will be shortly your WordPress-config file, there is no need to put them somewhere else too. Now let's see using direct admin. A regular user of a single site web hosting account logs in normally. Then click on MySQL management. If this is not readily visible, perhaps your host needs to modify your package to activate MySQL, then follow part C, which is listed over here. A reseller account or admin account may need to click the user level. They also must first log in as a reseller if the relevant domain is a reseller's primary domain, or log in as a user if the domain is not a reseller's primary domain. If a reseller's primary domain, then when user logged in as a reseller, you simply click the user level. How if the relevant domain is not the reseller's primary domain, then you must log in as a relevant user. Then click MySQL management. If not readily visible, perhaps you need to return to the reseller or admin level and modify the manage user package or manage reseller package to enable MySQL. Then in MySQL management, click on the small words, click create new database. Here you are asked to submit two suffixes for database and its usernames. For maximum security, use two different sets of 4 to 6 random characters. Then the password field has random button that generates an 8-character passwords. You may also add more characters to the password for maximum security. Then click on create. The next screen will summarize the database username, password and host name, and be sure to copy and paste these into the text file for future references. The third step coming up is to set up the WordPress configuration file, that is wordpress-config.php. You can either create and edit a WordPress config.php file yourself